Welcome at the Tricoach presentation. I hope you all survived the party and the soccer games of last night. I'm Roland Kersens. I'm a project manager slash product owner at Tricoach. And this is Gert Rottenhelm. He's our lead developer on Magnolia. And we are going to talk about our technical road trip and roadmap on the project, which we have been working on in the last couple of months, which is trying to implement a Tricoach SaaS solution based on Magnolia CMS and Konecart, the e-commerce engine. We have an old-fashioned agenda for this presentation. We're quite new to the Magnolia community as a partner. Actually, we have become a partner when Magnolia released Magnolia 5. So we want to tell you something about Tricoach, our company, what our aims are, our expertise. Then we want to focus on how we became involved in a Tricoach SaaS solution, elaborate on the goals of our SaaS project, and then focus on the technical issues in the implementation of the SaaS solution, and in particular on the lessons learned while developing the SaaS solution. And then there's, of course, time for questions and answers. First, Tricoach. Tricoach is a company based in Veenendaal and in Skopje, in Macedonia. It was founded in 1999 by three coders, hence the name Tricoach. It sounds a bit funny in English, but it's logical if you say it in Dutch. There are about 60 employees, of which 20 are based in the Netherlands, in Macedonia, and 30 in the Netherlands. And we have a customer based in the Netherlands, Belgium, and the UK. We're actually a software development company, so we are focusing on web development, but we are not a full-service agency. We are software developers using agile development, and we are specialized in providing digital marketing and e-commerce solutions. This is actually our mission statement. So the focus is on providing customer experience management solutions and e-commerce solutions. Basically, Java-based solutions. We started out as being a Java development company delivering bespoke solutions. And from 2011 onwards, we are focusing on implementing product-based solutions. We actually became one of the first implementation partners of Adobe Experience Manager. And from there went on to look for other product implementation products which we could implement, which would complement Adobe Experience Manager. We soon found out that Experience Manager is focused on the enterprise market, is actually built on open source techniques, but is in itself a closed source solution. So we were looking for mid-market solutions which were open source and based on the same technology stack as Adobe Experience Manager. And that's why we found Magnolia in 2012. And recently we have added Intershop to our portfolio as being another high-end solution which complements Adobe Experience Manager. And to complement Magnolia, we've added Konecart to our portfolio. So we have two high-end solution based on Experience Manager and Intershop, and a mid-market solution which is focused on Konecart and Magnolia, basically. And the mid-market solution is open source, the high-end solution is closed source. If you look at our customer base, these are both enterprise companies operating on a European scale, and Dutch non-profit companies and even startup companies. The most well-known customer of us is Liberty Global, which uses the brand name UPC in the Netherlands and some other brand names in the other parts of Europe. It's a large telecom company. Maybe you may have heard of it. Of particular interest in relation to Magnolia is B+C. It's actually the public library of Leiden, which was our first implementation project for Magnolia. And that is also the hook to the Road Magnolia CMS. Well, it started in 2011 with Adobe Experience Manager, which may be strange to you. And as I said, we were looking for a mid-market solution which complements AEM, which is not as broad, not a CM exam solution, but a CMS-focused solution. A CMS-focused solution for the mid-market, which also includes an open-source edition. And if you look at Magnolia, in relation to the CXM solution, Magnolia, from our point of view, being a CXM provider using Adobe Experience Manager, Magnolia provides web content management solutions and DOM solutions, which fits into our mid-market proposition. In 2013, we did our first Magnolia CMS project, which was the B+C library website. It actually meant migrating or refactoring a website based on Magnolia 4 to a new Magnolia 5 website and integrating the book catalog and course catalog in it. In 2014, we discovered that in the mid-market, particularly in the Netherlands or Benelux, there is a growing market for a SaaS solution, web content management as a SaaS solution. If you look at the market in general, you will see that more of the web content management solutions are delivered using a SaaS model. It's growing if you compare it to on-premise solutions. So we decided that we want to offer a software service based on Magnolia SaaS to our customers, especially the mid-market customers. So we started this project actually by establishing a team and training a team, which was done by Natasha of Magnolia. And then in April started this new project, which has now been going on for about 2 months. Well, in June we released our first alpha release of the SaaS solution. And we are going to focus on what is in this SaaS release in relation to adapting Magnolia CMS to be suited for a SaaS solution. And we will continue this project. Our goal is to have, at the end of release 3, the third quarter, a first release of the SaaS solution available, and then continue developing the Tricode SaaS until the end of this year. To be able to do this, we defined some of the features which a cloud web content management service should contain. It should, of course, be a hosted CMS solution. It should contain managed hosting and CMS support services. It should have automated CMS and website provisioning. It should enable customer self-service. This is a particularly important feature for us. We are actually software developers. So our goal is that the SaaS subscriber can configure his website on his own without implementation consultancy needs and maintain it on his own without assistance. And we didn't want to opt for a hosted solution of an out-of-the-box Magnolia hosted solution, but we wanted to boost the CMS with additional and optional features, which people can buy, for instance, in the form of additional apps. So we added some new components and apps to the solution. Another part is that easy deployment should be enabled. It should be product-based. You should be able to upgrade your whole SaaS solution at once for all customers. So easy deployment should be implemented. And we wanted to have multiple product editions. There should be a basic edition just focusing on web content management, and an enhanced edition, a premium edition as you wish, which contains web content management and e-commerce. So actually, there's one slide missing. Okay. In the first project, not all of these seven features were in scope. We divided them, and we focused on enhancing Magnolia and integrating the e-commerce version of Kona Card, the e-commerce edition, in building the e-commerce edition with Kona Card. So we focused on customer web content management self-service, implementing product-based release management, so easy deployments. We developed some additional web content management and e-commerce features, and we focused on developing the multiple product editions. Actually, we built the enhanced edition consisting of web content management and e-commerce features, and we extracted the basic edition out of this. So if you look at the division, we defined some business needs and translated them into software requirements, and then defined implementation needs, which actually was what the development team was supposed to deliver. So customer self-service is translated into the software requirement of a simplified Magnolia CMS configuration, basically a pre-configuration, which enables the SaaS subscriber to do the configuration of his website by himself. without assistance from implementation consultants or developers. Then product release management, as I said, it's basically simplified deployments. So we defined some implementation needs which enable simplified product deployments. Then we added some additional web content management e-commerce features, particularly the storefront components, which we made in Magnolia to enable integration of the Konecart e-commerce engine. And then the multiple product editions. The basic cloud VCM web content management edition is running on a simple VM. For the e-commerce edition, we want to have a high availability hosting environment. And we defined what a high availability hosting environment should be and how Magnolia should be implemented on it. So our project goal in the end is to have not a hosted out-of-the-box Magnolia solution, which still needs implementation consultancy and bespoke development by a service provider like Tricode, but to deliver an end-user solution consisting of a CMS and e-commerce functionality, an e-commerce product, which a SaaS subscriber who has only web content management knowledge can use without further assistance on his own.
So.
And that was the assignment for the technical team, and Gert was now explaining how these business goals were implemented and developed into solutions.
So, this is the technical part. Well, the goals has been set. Over a little year ago, we started looking into Magnolia. I started searching the internet. And basically, this is a summary of the requirements which has been set by our product owner. Let's go through by them. We start with product release management, build and deploy. Well, as I said, this is our implementation need. Create a simple Magnolia CMS deployment with a product WAR file. As I said, over a year ago, I started searching the internet for information, found this blog from 2011. It's written by Gregory Joseph from Magnolia. And yeah, this after reading this, I just dropped my just downloaded Tomcat bundle and start developing Magnolia in my Eclipse environment. It is basically about Maven. We are a Java company, so we like Maven. The interesting part is that at first, you see a little progress going on also in the Maven archetype. So first I needed to find dependencies myself for a particular Magnolia version, but now it has evolved in just a simple dependency. We provide just a Magnolia version, and the dependencies of the modules are just added themselves. So yeah, it's very easy to create Magnolia projects. There's another one. It seems to be a series. So this is about how you don't deploy Magnolia, but deploy a project. So we are able to build Magnolia. Now it's about deploying. It's basically about a single WAR file deployment in multiple configurations. The blog post was very interesting. Basically, we took the advices there and we added some additional features to it. What we have added is a extra property, which, well, as you probably all know, that Magnolia saves data content in a MySQL database, for example, but it also saves something to the file system. In the blog post, it was just a hard-coded path of the file system, and we just added a new property. So we can just configure this from starting Tomcat, for example, by adding a system property. And then it will be saved in the path we have added here. So basically, all good. We have a deployment or WAR file. So how do we simplify the release deployment? As a Java company, we are using Jenkins for continuous integration. this is our basic deployment build pipeline. If we commit something, commit code, it will be built automatically, it will be tested, and then if everything is okay, then it will be deployed in our Nexus. What we have added extra is a release job. It's just a simple matter of pressing the run, this job, and then the release completely automatic will be created. And then a new snapshot version for development will be created automatically, so we can start developing again. Well, next step, automate deployment. Well, we started, like many others maybe, with just a wiki page describing, okay, these are the steps you have to take to deploy Magnolia. We have done several deployments by these instructions. And after a while, we wrote scripts and start using the scripts instead. Well, the next step is, okay, let's use Jenkins to start the scripts. And that's a process we are just need to finish yet, but we are 99% there. So basically, it's in progress, still in progress, but it is doable. Okay, customer cell service, middleware, pre-configuration. These are our business needs and implementation needs. Well, we should have to easy to deploy and upgrade middleware software like Tomcat, Apache, MySQL. It should be having high availability for our e-commerce system and scale, and it should have secure connections and secure data storage. Well, this is probably, you all know this this picture. It's about the deployment models basically done by Magnolia. They have a standard, three virtual machines, three servers. Every server contains one Tomcat public Magnolia instance, for example. We have a minimal one, which is basically an author and a public on one server. And we have the reduced version, which is basically two variants on this. And basically, we decided to go with for the high availability for the reduced form. One public on one virtual machine, and one public and one author on the other. Basically, it is more cost effective to go with this one instead of the standard. If we take this model into more detail, we have a MySQL server containing all the data for all the customers. Of course, we have two virtual machines containing our Magnolia instances. In front of that, an Apache proxy server. Well, Apache, you don't want Tomcat directly connected to the public, so we need Apache. Basically, it's our proxy and load balancer in front of the Tomcat instances. And we decided to use the Apache to handle the SSL connections and not configure the Tomcat instances to handle SSL connections for the customer. Basically, this is what we're trying to accomplish for the secure SSL connections. Author, of course, is always on SSL. But the public sites, it can be HTTP or HTTPS. But that poses a problem for us. So we have pages. How do we know when to redirect to HTTPS if you're not on HTTPS? Well, Apache provides us mod rewrite. We just provide the pages like login or register, and then we rewrite to HTTPS if you're not on HTTPS. But what happens? This is basically how it looks like in Magnolia. But what happens if a content editor changes the page structure? This obviously doesn't work anymore. So we have to create a solution for this. And what we have done is, well, we have added a SSL-enabled property to the components which needs to be secured. The pages where the components are placed are looking into the components list and then okay, we have an SSL enabled component, and then it will just issue a redirect, and that will be handled by Apache. So basically, it doesn't matter anymore which components or which page needs to be on SSL. This simplifies the Apache configuration, and the components just basically provides us the information when a page should be running in HTTPS. There's another pre-configuration, more on the Magnolia. Well, this is just the basic stuff you're probably all aware of. We have a super user account. Well, that's some accounts you won't give to a normal user. And yeah, super user as a password is not very secure. We also need some privileges on the user, like groups, authorization and stuff. But basically, this is all what Magnolia provides. We have only created an installation task for the super user account. So during deployment, the super user password will automatically be changed. So we don't have to do this in the configuration. And basically, we are using the security app bootstrap file. So we're creating a configuration in the security app and take an export and then put it in our artifacts, and that will be automatically also deployed. Well, basically, this is what an administrator of a SaaS should contain. It should be usable to add users or add folders, but it doesn't have those features in the system path, so it can't create or read system users anymore. We defined some basic groups, and with those basic groups, we also have some basic roles containing the privileges. So all kind of basic stuff of Magnolia. So it's not nothing fancy here, but we need to do this. So let's go to the additional features that our product owner wanted. And let's focus on templates and themes. Well, these are the implementation needs we have defined. We need some page templates, mobile first. It should be easy to style or brand the website by a customer. Maybe use a market-leading web front-end development framework for layouts. Well, maybe you all know Bootstrap, but we decided to go with Foundation CSS framework. It's a little bit the same, or a little bit, it's practically the same as Bootstrap, but it has some nice features. So that's why we have chosen for Foundation. And all of this will be in our new Foundation templating kit, which is just a module we can install and provides us the page templates. So why Foundation CSS framework? Well, first of all, it's full responsive. It has the mobile first directly in it. So they design directly for a mobile phone instead of for a desktop. It has standardized markup, which is easy to override. It has a company behind it and a large user community like Bootstrap. Bootstrap is a little bit larger, I think, but it's large enough. And yeah, we thought maybe it's time for an alternative to the SDK. So basically, we have created a custom theme, and you see that it is completely responsive, out of the box, just a single theme. You don't have to create a different theme for this. So what have we changed? This is basically the resources app. As you see, it contains a theme. It's called My Theme, but we have added a new action to it. It's called Upload Theme Zip File. With this action, we can just create or upload a zip file containing the CSS and images needed for the theme. So it will be automatically inserted in our resources app. And basically, if we want to change the theme, we just select the CSS into our Site Manager app, which I will explain later on, which basically turning this, which is the Foundation default theme, into this just by adding one CSS overriding the classes, overriding the selectors in the basic foundation CSS. We have more additional features, modules, and app. One particular feature our product owner wants is, it should be easy and secure for application configuration. We needed some standard Magnolia CMS modules, for example, the form module and the imaging module. We needed some website blog integration and website e-commerce integration. Let's start with easy and secure configuration. I think you all know the configuration app in Magnolia. It works if you are a developer, but you won't give this to a normal user. You can create typos and no validation will occur. So basically what we have done, we defined a dialog giving the same possibilities to change the configuration, but provides you validation. So basically, still standard Magnolia 5 feature. So this is basically the standard form module. We didn't do much to the form module. We only changed the templates. We are still using the dialogues, but we added our foundation-based templates to it. A nice part of the form module, or the foundation, comes with plugins, so they have also a Foundation Byte plugin, which has HTML5 form validation in it. So with very little code, we can provide client-side validation. Basically, we only have to provide the data a byte on the form, and we can provide HTML5 validation tags or attributes to our tags. And that's about it. So we have client-side validation, but also the form-based, form module-based, server-based validation. So a very nice plugin. Well, the same goes for the standard imaging module. We created some standard generators, which are the small, medium, and large. But Foundation comes also with a plugin which can load responsive images. So basically, it's called the interchange plugin. It's the same, just add an attribute data interchange, remove the source tag because the plugin will create the source tag for you. And you provide in the data interchange all the URLs for different media queries which you want to use. So we have the small here, we have the medium, and we have a large. And the interchange plugin will get the correct image from out the imaging module. We have added a NoScript tag just for fallback. So if you don't have JavaScript, then this image will be shown to the user. Well, the block module. The block module, it is a nice module. This is basically what we were starting in 2013. While Magnolia was still in its beta phase, we start creating a content app just to make sure that we get the knowledge about content-centric apps. This is our first content-centric apps. It survived several Magnolia releases, and it's still there. So basically, this is a real configured content-centric app without too much Java code involved. And we created some components which you can use in the pages. So basically, what we are seeing here are content from the block module, block content, and we only have two pages, one for the summary, and if you click one of the blog posts, then we have a detailed component somewhere else, and you will go there. E-commerce. We have done some research on particular e-commerce systems. We have looked into Broadleaf, and we have looked into Konecart, and well, we decided to go with Konecart. Broadleaf is still on our roadmap, but it's basically something you can use in the project for customization. Konecart is more feature-rich, so that's why we decided for to use it in our standard proposition. Maybe you know, but this has been done before. It has been done in, I think it was Magnolia 4.3, which has Konecart Community Edition integration, but it has been done by merging the WAR files of Konecart and Magnolia. Well, I'm not sure if you all have seen the presentation yesterday about e-commerce integration, but it's not very maintainable. So we decided not to take that path and use the SOAP interface of Konecart instead. It is loosely coupled, so we can have a separate Konecart installation. We can upgrade Konecart, and Magnolia just uses the SOAP interface to get the data from. It also means that we can't use the standard JSP files Konecart provides. That was in the earlier integration. That could be done in the earlier integration. They used the same JSP files provided by Konecart. So we have to create our own free marker-based components. We decided to go with the standard login, register, and my account components. We have, of course, a product catalog and a basket and a basic checkout. What's on our roadmap is basically, with the new Magnolia 5.3, is to integrate the Konecart admin in Magnolia. What we have done now, this is basically the 5.2 Magnolia version. We are using the iframe app. So we are showing, this is basically how it looks like, Konecart. This is what we are using now. But with new Magnolia 5.3, we are able to create the app and use the SOAP interface to just get the data in a more Magnolia look and feel. So yeah, this is basically something. This is the shopping basket. This is a free market component we have created. It's all foundation based. We could do something on the styling, but that's basically in the CSS. But this is what we are currently working on. It is a lot of work, creating all the components one by one. But it is in progress, and I think we can manage to have a real fine e-commerce integration with this. This is another component. It's just the basic checkout. We have placed an order, or we can place an order. We have something in our basket. And this is basically the checkout component we have in our system. So how does this look like in Admin Central or in the App Launcher? This is basically what a SaaS administrator will see if he logs in. It has, of course, the site manager containing all configuration for the sites. Of course, our blogging app and our e-commerce admin app, and basically the contacts and assets, because we're using the assets app for having the images which can be used in Konecart also. So basically, this is our conclusion.
Yeah, so the whole goal of our Tricode SaaS solution is not just to deliver an on-demand hosted Magnolia CMS solution, but also to enhance the CMS with new features which an end user can use and enable an end user to configure a website in the CMS by himself without implementation consultancy needs, without additional development. So actually deliver a product instead of a platform on which additional work needs to be done to deliver an end solution. And there was, in the keynote speech, there was some talk about a Magnolia on demand initiative by Magnolia, our take is more focused on developing a solution, so software development instead of hosting. And that's basically what we are still working on and maybe continue to work on until the end of this year. So are there any questions?